I'm Loretta Whitman, and I'm the director of Curtain Call, the musical theater ensemble.
We've had the opportunity to sing a lot of musical theater songs. We've worked on individual numbers, group numbers, things that are more contemporary.
As someone who likes musical theater, you get a lot of acting training. You get a lot of working with like scripts and working with the librettos, but we don't always get to sit down and just sing. And I think that's a really, really cool part about this ensemble.
We were able to bring in Heath Saunders, who is both a Broadway performer, but he is also a composer and lyricist. And we were also able to bring in James Ballard, who is our artistic director for the Curtain Up Songwriters Workshop.
Having Heath and James come visit was just an incredible experience.
I met Heath, he was sitting under a tree on the Dell talking to my choir director, and I was about to go into a voice lesson, and I saw them sitting there, and my choir director called me over. And I was like, oh, whoa, like this is a real person. He's not just a picture on our poster. It's very cliche to be like, oh, these people are down to earth. They're real people, but that's exactly who they are. When Heath was there working with us, he really focused on what was written on the page. That was kind of his thing.
And he was like, all right, here's what I want. Here's what I envisioned when I wrote it. And let's do it and see if we can get there. And we did, and it was a lot of fun. I think it was eye-opening for all of us as a group to see how Heath worked and to like sort of just like, oh, like that's how we should be, like throughout everything we should be like just going through and getting things done.
We like had all of the necessary like the notes and the rhythms when we were learning the music, but he was like, you've gotta like tell me the story, like that's what this is about. And performing is fun, and that was a lesson that he brought with him. He was like, you guys need to look like you're enjoying yourselves. If you look like this is terrible, like this is not going to be a fun performance. People are not going to enjoy it. If you're miserable, the audience is going to be miserable. And so he was able to give us direction that tightened up just the musicality of the song, but also infused it with this passion and energy that we didn't have previously. And I thought that that was just so exciting.
When students get an opportunity to do something like this, they usually rise to the level that you want them to go to. And my students certainly did that. And I am so proud of the work that they do.
They told me that I got to work with Preston Max Allen, which was awesome. I looked him up, obviously. And I was like, what the heck? Like, this guy has a show that is opening off Broadway, and he's writing a song for me. Like, I was ecstatic. Like I was just like, this is insane. This is so freaking awesome. I'm so excited. And he wrote a really amazing, hilarious song that fit me, I felt like, really well.
Hello, humans, don't be frightened. Though I know it must seem strange, in a world of good and evil, I am here to help bring change.
This was literally the last week of school.
We had really like a week of consistent rehearsals, and then we had a performance. I got my music maybe a week and a half before we performed it. The curveball was that Elizabeth, she was supposed to sing the middle part, but she completely lost her voice essentially that week.
This was a very different sort of experience because I was sick all week, which is not something that as a performer you look forward to at all during performance week.
It was a three-part harmony and she was doing the middle. And anybody who knows anything about music knows that's probably the hardest section to learn.
And so Addie Weaver, who was in Curtain Call last semester, but because of like a class conflict, she wasn't in it this semester. She stepped in and she, the day before, came in and learned that part. And then she sang it the next day with me and Sloan, and it went really, really well.
Let me end.
anything in theater that can happen will happen. There are always complications like that. Every performance that you see is special to you and that audience. And in some ways, audiences love knowing that this is a special one-time event that will never happen again.
And there's nothing else to back it up with, and it's just an exhilarating experience to be able to walk off that stage going, I was the first person that ever did that. That's cool.
My biggest takeaway from having James and having Heath here this week is to just be invested in what you're doing and be interested and have fun, to keep a perspective of what you're doing and why you're doing it and how that translates to the audience. I think that's something that kind of transcends theater. Remembering, this is what I'm doing, this is why I'm doing it, and I'm gonna do it. That kind of spirit and that purpose and that drive is something that's helpful no matter what, whether you're in theater or you're a music student or you're a psychology student.